Okay, for this next one, I want you to try to find something. It could be a door frame again, something that you can keep your body next to, just to help keep you honest. I find for these ones, a rack works really well for me, but obviously you guys might not be doing this in a place where you have a rack available. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring my hip through an entire rotation of all the ranges of motion that it has. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring this leg up as high as I can. I'm going to bring it out, and then from here I'm going to rotate. So I'm trying to keep my knee as high as possible while getting my shin parallel to the floor. Then I'm going to come back down here, okay? And we're going to come up again, out to the side. I'm going to try to rotate to keep that knee as high as possible, and then back and down. While I do that rotation, I'm trying my best to keep my torso as still as possible. That's why I use this rack. It helps keep me a little bit honest. You'll see sometimes people will get some weird torso movements to try to compensate for that movement. But I'm going to show you one more. We're going to go up, out, and then rotate, trying to keep my torso as still as possible, and then back in. Okay? You can also then go the opposite way. So I'm going to go back, out, rotating the other way, and then across and down. It's good to mix up that so we change up the direction that we're moving. And obviously do the same thing on both sides. If you have a mirror, that will really help keep you honest as well. You'll be able to see if there's any torso movement happening there.